Hey up guys, Judgmental here with episode 2 of my Rise of the Tomb Raider Let's Play. Last time we ended with a very impressive cutscene which showed us Lara narrowly escaping an Apache helicopter and an exploding jeep before falling off the edge of a cliff. We were also told the name of the rival group searching for the Prophet's tomb, Trinity. We met a mysterious woman named Anna, who seems to be very strongly connected with Lara's father and obviously herself. But for now, all we know is that we're in Syria searching for immortality. Right, let's see what happens next.
Could this really be it?
Nice dark, dank space. Classic Tomb Raider, especially with the flare out now as well.
Some kind of marker. Can't quite make out the translation, but this word. Prophet! This is it. Dad was right.
Okay. So we don't want the light track at least.
Some sort of marker. Byzantine script.
Ooh, can't translate.
Quite make it out.
Yeah, we've got survival instinct. This is what we want. This tells us where to go, what we're looking for.
Okay.
And any hidden items.
Shown here, performing healing miracles. Dad's notes mention this.
Ooh, increasing language skill. That's a nice touch. Obviously, some things we can't read until later on in the game.
These are the miracles of the Prophet of Constantinople, unjustly murdered by order of Trinity.
I'm not going to try and use survival instinct too much in this game. I used it in the last one pretty much all the time, almost lived in it. Wasn't the best. Rather just get on with the game, see what's going off. Looks like I can now translate this monolith.
My Greek is still a little rusty, but it's pointing to something hidden nearby.
Okay, so it's telling me about something hidden just
I'll mark down
over
the
there. Fair enough. Another mean to upgrade. That's not bad. Obviously not being able to upgrade anything as of yet. I'm sure that'll happen same as the last one again. At camps when you save.
A secret entrance.
Weren't really all that secret, were it? Big glowing light coming through the other side. There we go, that's a proper
tomb. It's amazing. If only Dad could have seen this.
Very nice graphics. Love how that water just dissipates into a mist over that side. Very nice touch. Right, let's go and have a look. Obviously, there's no easy way to get over, I'm sure. Never is. Oh, can you hear that helicopter again? They're obviously not already here, they've just flown over your head. You're closer than they are. Oh great, here we go. Why does she manage to break everything she touches? Very subtle. And yet again, she's holding her stomach from injury. Seems to be a theme with this loss.
The Order of Trinity pursued the Prophet and his people relentlessly until finally confronting them in their hidden oasis.
Nice tight space. Very nice graphics there on cobwebs. Yet again. Very, very nice visually.
Damn
oh, great.
It. Come on.
Whoa. Okay. She got scorpions and stuff. Surely if there's all these dead bodies, there can't actually be anything else alive in here. A few more dead bodies. Wonder what actually happened in here. Great. Thanks for letting us know.
Pilgrims. The Order of Trinity.
It's tending to explain everything that I could really ask at the moment. A bit dubious about the opening cutscene in the last episode.
The Prophet that was slain by the Order of Trinity.
Easily outshone in the cutscene that followed that.
My son. The Order of...
I'm not going to bother reading all the relics and stuff I pick up. I'm specifically not going to go out my way to find any of them, unless of course if anybody does want to know, does want me to go find them, go out my way to find them, that's no problem. I can do another video on that. Just obviously leave it in the comments. I'll go and have a look.
They're blasting their way in.
Nice to use a trademark pistol. Oh, here we go. Something else broken. Okay, so it looks like we've got water pouring in from here, and let's do this first.
Let's hope this works.
Yep, raising the water level. Okay. Pretty obvious raft, I'm sure. Find something a bit more elaborate later on. Slow motion. There we go. Oh wow. Helps her press the right button. Tap B rapidly, swim faster, always helpful. Come on, don't drown. There we go. Anybody that's played the old Tomb Raiders would know exactly what I'm thinking here. Swan dive! Oh, close. Oh well. Right. Chances are I've got to get up there. So, I'm going to have to raise the water level again.
Got to find a way to get up higher. Maybe I can raise the water.
Obvious. Should have just had a look around. said earlier, you could actually almost live in survival instinct on this game and pretty much know where you're going all the time. Don't like to do it like that, I like to figure stuff out for myself. Might not be the best course of action, but hey ho. Might use it eventually. Might need to use it eventually. Right, what's that going to do? Oh, it's just another raft. I don't know, maybe not. Just use it to fill the water up again. Nearly there now. It's not going to be that straightforward, is it? We're going to have to go around one up ways. There we go. Try this way. Oh, boxing floor. Spike trap. Nasty.
Damn. They're almost inside.
Spike trap's not around here. Yeah, there we go.
My lord, what do you say?
Right. What next? Surely I've got to raise the water even more to get it up so I can reach that second setup there. Ooh, what's that? No challenge. No. Why not? Probably missed some already though. Not going to be a good start. Whoa, another one. Whoa! No need for two traps, one after another. I don't know, just reflection of my flare. Thought I saw something to collect then. Right. Yet again, looks like raising the water. Whoa! No need for that. Don't look like it's as straightforward as the last ones, but we'll see what happens. To be honest guys, it's pretty repetitive at the moment. All I'm doing is finding ways to raise the water. Just so I can progress slightly. Okay, I'm sure I'll have to shoot that raft down. Unless I miss twice in a row. Okay, obviously not supposed to do that. Here I am. Nope, obviously not supposed to do that. Oh, there it is. There we are. I know what I'm doing now. Obviously a bit more of an elaborate trap than I thought it was. There we go, we can follow now. Not washing me up. Oh no, it is going to wash me away still. Come on, we can't be that far away now. Yeah, there we go. Should hopefully be a clean climb now. Not as though these shelves look very friendly. Bound to collapse on me. Oh no.
Found you. empty. No! No! What did I miss?
Hey, down here! Set the charges! Prophet's tomb. After all this time.
And the artifact?
Inside. God willing. Open it. Carefully. It could be extremely dangerous.
Who the hell are you?
You're a smart woman. I suspect you already know.
Trinity.
Where is the artifact?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play games with me! You led us to this place.
Look. It was empty when I got here. There was no body and definitely no artifact.
Right then. Yet again, she's managed to wreck everything. First major escape out goal. We won't have to sprint, huh? Always have a tendency to jump too early on these sort of things, mate. These sort of everything breaking around you, fall collapsing around you. Oh, yeah, I missed that one.
Jonah!
Laura!
There's so much I need to tell you, I don't...
Did you find the Prophet's tomb?
Yes, but I was followed.
What? By who?
They call themselves Trinity. They tried to kill me.
What the hell is going on here? You're starting to scare me.
The tomb was empty, but I think they were looking for the divine source.
The artifact your father was after?
There's more. I found this symbol in the tomb. I knew I'd seen it before. It was driving me insane. That's when it hit me. I saw it here, in one of Dad's books. Listen to this. The lost city of Katesh, said to have disappeared in Siberia sometime in the 12th century. Legend says that on the eve of the invasion by the Mongol horde, it sunk beneath a lake.
What does this have to do with the Prophet's artifact?
The same symbol.
Laura.
If the divine source is hidden in the ruins of Katesh,
waiting to be found, then I have to go.
To Siberia? Are you kidding me?
Just think. If this thing could really unlock the secret of immortality, it would change everything. Sickness, suffering, death, gone.
Are you listening to yourself?
Jonah, we've been through so much together. You know there's more out there. This could be real.
I don't care if it's real. I've lost too many friends. I don't want to lose you too.
Dad never made the connection to Katesh. He gave up everything for this.
Including you. Stop blaming yourself for what happened. He made his own bed.
I can't give up on him. Not now. It's all I have.
No, it isn't! If you stayed still for 5 minutes, maybe you'd see that. Shit, Lara. What are we gonna do?
I led them to it, Jonah. If the divine source is real, we've got to find it first.
Siberia it is, then.
You can hear me. Go back. Please don't try to find me. I need to do this alone.
So, looks like, in short, what we've got there is Lara going a bit insane from trying to follow her on with her father's work, Jonah pretty much calling her out on it and then walking out, Trinity member showing up, Jonah jumping to save Lara, still in the book in the process, the Trinity member that is, and then Jonah agreeing to come to Siberia to help her uncover the truth. And then, of course, after Lara got hit by that avalanche, she's just ditched him, which, to be totally honest, I feel pretty bad if I were Jonah. But hey, we'll press on. But not this time. Next time, join me for episode 3. It should be out tomorrow, where hopefully we'll see what's going off and actually start surviving out in this cold wilderness. Right, thanks for watching. Please hit the like button if you can. Comment if you feel as though I'm missing something. Try not to give any spoilers though, please, and subscriptions are very, very much appreciated. Thank you, and I'll see you next time, guys.